Hello guys, by the end of this video we'll have this looping simple animation without the use of rigging. It's a tutorial for beginners to get a hang on the basic features of animating with grease pencil. And we are of course in the latest version, Blender 2.93. So we have our cute little bat and it has a number of layers. It has a wings layer, it has a body, it has a layer with eyes and a layer with a blink. So we have a blink here and some eyes here, and we have a mouth layer and a teeth layer. We are here in a dop sheet and with grease pencil selected, so we have these keyframes here. Let's duplicate them, shift D and go to frame 20. We will have a very slow animation, but we will be able to speed it up later. So we go to frame 20 and go to edit mode, and then we select our wing here. We hit L on the keyboard to select all the points of the wing, and now we will rotate it by hitting R and then hitting Y, so that it rotates on the Y axis. And then we type in the keyboard -30, and then we hit enter to have our wing like this. So rotate by -30 degrees, and then we hit S to resize the wing, but resize on the X axis only. So we hit X again, so S then X, and if the scale of our wing is 1, the X scale is 1, we will change it to 0. So on the number pad in the keyboard, 0.85, and then we hit enter, and then we select our other wing. We hit L to select all the points, and then R to rotate, and then Y to rotate only on the Y axis, and then we type in 30 this time and not -30 degrees, and we hit enter, and again S and X to resize on the X axis only, and we hit 0.85 and enter. Now we hit shift and drag our mouse over the other wing, and then we hit L to select everything, and then G, Z, and we move our wings like this. So we want this point here to be here with the other point of the wing. Luckily, of course, we have onion skinning. G again, Z, and move these two wings here, and voila. Now we select everything. Oh, let's unhide our eyes so that they get selected with the rest, and hit A. So our bat will have its wings flapping like this. So when the wings are like this and then it does this, it like pushes the air and the bat will go up. So that's why here in frame 20 we want it to go up. So we hit G with everything selected and Z and move it up a little bit. This is our basic animation. Okay, and now what we're gonna do is let's deselect everything. Is everything deselected? Nice. We go to frame 40 and then select these frames in frame 1 here, and then we hit shift D to duplicate them to frame 40. Very nice. And now there's one more thing to do, is to interpolate these guys. So we go between these two keyframes here, and then we go to grease pencil, interpolate sequence. I think in Blender 2.92 there was a button here for interpolation, but here in Blender 2.93 we have a new tool that is the interpolate button that you can hit here, and then use your left click to interpolate as you wish, like this. Okay, shift Z, and we have the interpolate sequence here under grease pencil. Or if you are in draw mode, it is here under draw. Let's try it here in draw mode. So interpolate sequence, hit it here, and then we got this menu here, and you see that all the layers were interpolated, but there's an option here to have only the active layer interpolated. I think this one is the default one, but we want all the layers interpolated, so we use this. And voila, now we go here and we use the interpolation again. So draw, let's use it in the edit mode. Okay, edit mode, and then grease pencil, and then interpolate sequence. So let's test our animation. Here we go. It works perfectly. So this is it almost. What we can do now, I guess, is to hide our blink. And then we will use this guy here. We will add a modifier to our guy. Let's go to object mode and add an offset. No, a time offset modifier. Check here, custom range, and replace the end frame. Okay, from 1 to 39. The reason I put in 39 is because these frames are duplicate. So the frame in 1 and in 40 is duplicate. So if you put like 1 to 40, you will have two identical frames playing. But like this, we have no duplicates. So here it is, animating very slowly. But there's an option here, it's a scale option. So if we lower this number here to like 0.8, the animation should be faster, I think. So I had it all wrong, guys. So the scale is above 1 is faster, and the under 1 is slower. We don't want it slow because that will lower our frame rate. That's why we created a slow animation. So if we want it slow, we have this smooth slow animation, and if we want it faster, we can have this, and it works fine and smooth. So it's better to have a slow animation in the start than a fast one, and then you try to slow it down and you lower your frame rate. And then we have another option here, is the frame offset. So if you have like several bats here, let's duplicate this guy. So we duplicate it, Shift D, we create a second bat. So with this bat, we use this offset. Let's make it like 5, maybe, or 6. And here we put 1. When they animate, but you see that, yeah, they don't go up at the same time, and they don't voila. So there's only one thing to add, is a blink. That's why we have a blink layer, and for that we will go to, we choose dub sheet here, we are in frame 1, we choose our guy here, we go to the layers, and in the blink we put here insert keyframe. And also in the eyes, we will insert a keyframe. And then we go like here, for example. I think what I should do is just yes. Yes. So, yeah. And then we go like 3 frames with the right arrow on the keyboard. 1, 2, 3. And then again, we open the eyes and hide the blink layer. So here we have a blink. And then we can duplicate this as we wish. And have, so Control C, Control V, yes, and have as many blinks as we want. I don't know if we can make this blinks loop. Let's go to the graph editor, let's go here, let's hit N here, and then go to modifiers, yes, cycle, and we do the same here. Okay, cycles, and let's try to play our animation again. So 1 blink, 2 blinks, 3 blinks, 4 blinks, 5 blinks. So this is it. We have our animation. Let's delete this guy, let's duplicate this guy again, Shift D, duplicate. And then again change the offset here to like 15, and then we go to the dub sheets, let's put the object transform, hit G, put it in frame 1, and then we change these guys a little bit so they don't blink at the same time. So let's move this a little bit like this, G, and then space these ones a little bit here maybe, and then let's try again our animation. So they fly, they fly, they fly. They blink, they blink, they blink. Everything works fine, and this is it. If you want to support the channel, I will put this file in Gumroad, link in the description, for just $3 to support my work here. Thank you for watching and see you in another video. Peace.